What's up, y'all? It's your girl EVE, and this is The Ebb Effect. Okay, so first of all, I want to start by saying thank you guys so much. I have officially reached the 1,000 subscriber mark. And at the beginning of the year, I set a hefty goal. And to be honest, I am so grateful to be at this point right now. I didn't think that I would get to 1,000 this fast. I consider it to be fast. 1,000 may not be a lot to a lot of people, but it is a lot to me. So I am truly grateful and thankful for all 1,000 and I think 80 of you who hit that subscribe button. If you are new here, I hope that you too will consider hitting that subscribe button as well and joining the fam. So on this channel, I am just basically sharing everything that I love. And right now I am loving fragrances a whole lot. I've loved fragrances all my life, honestly, but right now this is what I'm highlighting on my channel. So I hope that after watching today's video that you too will consider hitting that subscribe button and joining us over here, okay? All right, so secondly, I wanna give a shout out to all my creators, whether that be Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok as well. I wanna give a shout out to you because there are a lot of struggles that go on behind the scenes, okay? And I think a lot of people don't realize or recognize how much work it takes into producing just one video. All right, so I had footage for about three videos already filmed and I lost that footage. So I've been away because I've been trying to regroup and just kind of gather myself and get back in the swing of things and just keep pushing forward. So if nobody sees you, I see you, okay? I see you, I understand the struggle is real out here. There are times when you don't wanna film and you push through and you do it anyway. There are times when you film and the footage is trash and so you have to start over. Matter of fact, 2 days ago, I filmed my Sephora haul from the VIB sale, got through it, ran the footage back and it wasn't giving what it needed to give. So I'm scrapping it. So yeah, I just wanted to give a special shout out to my creators because this is not easy. It's fun, don't get me wrong, it's fun, but there's a lot of stuff that goes on behind the scenes. So shout out to you. All right, so now that we've gotten the acknowledgements out the way, today's video is about layering. Now, this is one of the things that I love doing when it comes to my collection. So one of the best compliments, in my opinion, that you can get is you smell good, right? But usually that compliment is followed up with a question. What are you wearing? And for some people, they don't like sharing it because they don't want you smelling just like them. And for me, I am quite the opposite. I do not mind sharing what I'm wearing simply because fragrances have an additional factor, and that is your skin chemistry, okay? So the same fragrance on five different people is gonna have five different variations because their skin chemistry is all different. So today, I wanna go ahead and share some layering combos that I have gotten many compliments on that you could probably implement in your collection as well if you wanna kinda change up what your smell is. Just in case there are others in your circle who may be wearing the same singular fragrance, you can always do a layering combo to change it up. All right, so the first combo is actually one that I shared in a prior video, but I wanna touch on it just a little bit here. And that is Santal Noir from Dior. This is the private line from Dior. Now this is a gorgeous, gorgeous, but very strong and potent sandalwood and rose combination. That's primarily what I get from here, but it's absolutely beautiful in my opinion. I have read reviews that said that the sandalwood that they got in here was more on the creamier side. I unfortunately do not get that, but it's still a beautiful fragrance to me. It's very strong, so a couple sprays is all that you're gonna need when wearing this. This is really more, in my opinion, more of a fall, winter type vibe, but again, you know what my motto is. Wear what you want when you want to wear it, because that is exactly what I do. And because I do that, when I do want to wear this in slightly warmer temperatures, I want to soften it up. And so this would be my base, and I would soften it up with Bois d'Argent from Dior, again from the private line. Now, this is a beautiful iris and vanilla fragrance. I adore this, and it's obvious because I got the big bottle. This is the, I think the 8.5 bottle. This is gonna last me for a while. And I also got the big bottle of this because I wanted to be able to spray liberally. I did mention that this fragrance is more of a quiet confidence type fragrance, okay? This fragrance says that you've got it going on, but I don't have to blast. I'm not flashy, but I know I got it going on. It's a white t-shirt and jeans type of scent, and it stays closer to the skin. It doesn't project really loud. It's under moderate, okay? It's not too soft in my opinion, but it's a little less than moderate, but it's a gorgeous scent. So the iris and vanilla in here, paired with the sandalwood and Turkish rose in here, great combination. It rounds out the sandalwood note in here for me, and it gives it that creamy factor that I unfortunately don't get with this alone, okay? So gorgeous combination. I would primarily wear this in the fall and winter, but I can rock it in the spring too if I want to, because that's just what I do. Y'all, my hair is giving me the blues today. I don't know what it's doing, but it doesn't want to hold a curl. What is this? What is this? All right, so our next combination would perform best in the cooler months. But again, wear what you want when you want, because that is what we do over here, all right? So for our base, we are going to start off with Oud Satin Mood from MFK. Y'all, I absolutely love this scent. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful oud rose combo with a heaping dose of vanilla in here. This combination is absolutely beautiful. And anybody looking to kind of dip their toe in the oud pond, I would highly recommend checking this out. It's not a skanky type oud, in my opinion. It's not an off-putting type oud at all. The vanilla honestly helps to soften and round out the oud in here. But what I will say is sometimes I want it to be just a little bit different. I want to amplify that vanilla because I find, in my opinion, I find that this sits in the middle of being natural and synthetic. So the vanilla is a natural synthetic hybrid, in my opinion. That's what I'm going to call it. So when I want to kind of change up that vibe just a little bit, I like to pair it with Chanel Jersey. This is another favorite that I absolutely love. This is my most favorite out of the Chanel exclusive line. And I feel like Chanel gets a bad rap in general because people notate Chanel as old lady vibes. No, honey, this is rich. Rich auntie vibes, okay? Rich auntie vibes is what I get over here. And if you're a guy, rich uncle vibes, you know, whatever floats your boat. But I absolutely love this scent. This has vanilla and it has lavender in it. I believe it also has the note of tonka bean in here. And tonka bean can sometimes come off like it is a vanilla note, but I do believe that there's vanilla and tonka bean in here. But this is a beautiful, cozy scent. This scent is like, come and snuggle and cuddle up with me. I just absolutely love this. And when I pair this with the Oud Satin Mood, I get sexy coziness, all right? This is more than Netflix and chill kind of vibe, because if it starts off with Netflix and chill, it's gonna end differently, all right? There will be no movie watched. But this combination together just garnered so many compliments. I've worn this about 3 times between October and January, and the amount of compliments that I got from this combination was just endless, to be honest, endless. One time I did wear it to the Galleria, the mall, and I got stopped twice asking me what I was wearing. So I did share that I was wearing this combination. So if you have these two in your collection, I would say try this out and let me know what you think. All right, so for our next layering combo, I feel like both of these scents separately are great year-round. You can wear it summer, spring, winter, or fall. So for the base, we are going to start off with Bottega Veneta. And guys, this is a spicy, leathery note. I think there's like pink pepper or maybe Szechuan pepper. I think it's pink pepper in here. It opens up beautifully with that spicy pink pepper note. And then that leather just comes in, but it doesn't come in harsh. I am not a fan of leather. Tom Ford Ombre leather, Tom Ford Tuscan leather. I'm just not a fan of it because I don't like the leather note like that. But this leather is done so beautifully in this fragrance. It's not overpowering. is rounded out, honestly. So I mainly get spiciness and leathery notes, but I honestly feel like there is a suede note in here and a touch of some type of sweetness. I'm gonna say it has maybe like a hint of vanilla, maybe just a small tinge, because it does dry down. Just a little bit sweet, just a little bit sweet. It also has some earthiness in here that I do like. So I think there's oak moss in here too. But overall, I really, really love this fragrance. This is a great one that I stumbled upon. I really love it. So it's amazing by itself. But when I want to bring out that sweetness more in here, I like to pair it with, of course, something that's sweeter. So the sweet scent that I will pair this with is Dolce & Gabbana, the one. Now, this is a beautiful singular fragrance that opens up citrusy, and it has vanilla in it, of course. And I think I almost want to say it has a touch of honey as well. I kind of get honey vibes in here, but great citrusy white floral with some sweetness from vanilla and I think honey. Pairing that with the suede leatherness in here, opening up spicy. This is a great combination. You pop off spicy, but you dry down just being the perfect sweetheart. That is what you get from this combination. Beautiful, beautiful combination. Give this a try. All right, so for this next combo, these are scents that I just absolutely love. I love all of my fragrances in my collection, but these are just so amazing by themselves. So these are also light, in my opinion. They're light, so they can be worn year-round as well. So we are going to start off with Bal de Freak, and I've talked about this on my channel before. This is a beautiful, airy, woodsy, a bit citrusy, but the prominent note in here is the African marigold in here. Beautiful, gorgeous, unique scent. I absolutely love this by itself. When I first stumbled upon this, I didn't care for it because the lasting power was subpar. But when I gave it another shot, I oversprayed it. And when I overspray, this lasts wonderfully for me. So no more complaints there. And that's also why I got the bigger version of this, so that I can be a little bit more liberal in my sprays. So when I want to kind of amp this up and change it up just a bit, but I still long for that white floral in here and the airiness in here, I like to pair it with Mon Guerlain by Guerlain. Now this is a beautiful, beautiful lavender and vanilla scent. I also want to say that there's white florals in here as well, but the prominent notes in here is that lavender and the vanilla. I absolutely adore this scent. And this combination right here is the perfect, like, date type of scent. You know, this is a beautiful kind of romantic scent for the day. It's a little bit alluring, just a little bit alluring, but it doesn't give off, you know, take me now. It gives off flirtatiousness, in my opinion. So beautiful combination. Give it a whirl. Let me know what you think. Now, sticking with Mon Guerlain, as I mentioned, gorgeous lavender and vanilla scent, but this is an offender because by itself, with a few sprays, the lasting power is not great. I don't know about you, but for me, I do not get great longevity with this scent. But because it is a beautiful scent, I actually don't mind. And this will be in my collection forever and a day because I love this that much. When I think about this scent, I think about a woman who's truly got it going on. She has got her stuff together. And this is not like a boss chick type of woman that I'm speaking of. This is more of a feminine, delicate, kind of on the dainty side woman. Like, she is type A. She has her day structured out from the moment she opens her eyes in the morning to when she gets home from work, and she's got dinner already made and ready for the kids and hubby. She's got her stuff going on. She's got a full schedule of things to do, but never breaks a sweat and always, always smells good. That's what I get from this, all right? So when I want to kind of take her from day to night, I will pair her with Myrrh and Tonka from Jo Malone. Y'all, when I say that this is an amazing, sensual scent on its own, this is spectacular. And Jo Malone, the brand, is another offender for me. I absolutely love their scents, but the longevity is very lackluster. And so I am hesitant to build up my collection with a lot of Jo Malone fragrances just because the lasting power is not that great. And I know that you can layer with lotions and creams and whatnot, but sometimes I just want to be able to spray my fragrance and smell it for more than just a couple of hours without having to go through all the hoops just to get my fragrance to last long, okay? So, but this does not have that problem. This has great longevity. It opens up a bit spicy. It has a beautiful tonka bean, of course, and that incense, that myrrh incense, is sexy, all right? So when you put sexiness with this beautiful feminine woman, this is a match made in heaven, all right? There is no divorce when it comes to this marriage. This marriage is going to last forever and ever till death do them part, all right? This is a beautiful combination that is perfect for date night. Date night will end with a happy ending. I am just saying, it's that type of combination. Try this out if you have these in your stash. All right, so this next combo consists of two heavy hitters, in my opinion, that do wonderful by themselves and they can definitely stand alone. But when you want to change things up, you put them together and magic happens. So we're going to start off with our base, and that is YSL's Leap. Now, again, this is another, vanilla lavender scent. Can you guys tell that I love lavender? I love lavender, I love iris, and I definitely love vanilla. Now, this is a very popular fragrance in the community, so I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with how this smells. I actually prefer the original formulation better than the intense formula. I did get my nose on that, and it's good, but I actually prefer this one. I also did get a whiff of the EDT, which is actually not bad. I might consider picking up a small bottle of that, but out of all three right now, I'm really loving the original formulation. So when I want to change this up, because a lot of people have this scent, but again, I do not care about that. I don't care about my neighbor having the same fragrance as me, because how it emits off of my body is going to be different from how it emits off of his or hers. But when I want to change this up, I like to pair it with the kingpin of all fragrances, and that is BR540. Y'all, this combination right here is another amazing masterpiece that I just happened to stumble upon. And we all know what 540 smells like. That beautiful saffron in the opening. This gives off that burnt sugar cotton candy scent. It is gorgeous. Now, like many, for me, sometimes, I get this sometimes. Sometimes this does do the disappearing act on me. And so I find that when I layer these together, the lavender and vanilla in here grounds this scent so that it stays, okay? So it doesn't do the disappearing act when I pair these together. So I get a healthy blend of both of these together, and it's just, chef's kiss. I love this combo. Major, major compliments. These get compliments by themselves, but together, a force to be reckoned with. Try it out for yourselves. Now, I do want to say that there is no science to layering. A lot of this, honestly, for me was trial. I'll go into my stash, spray something, and if I get this feeling like it needs something else, I'll just try something else. I don't really have a formula in my head as to what goes with what. I just try it all out and see what resonates with me on my body and how it makes me feel. And a lot of the times it works out. Sometimes it just doesn't. Some things just don't go together. And sure enough, that has happened to me, and it was a catastrophe, but you just move forward. You scrub it off and then you try again with something else. Okay, so I've got one more layering combo that was my recent discovery, and I absolutely love it. This right now for me is my most favorite combo. I recently discovered it and I just cannot get enough, okay? So for our base on this one, we are starting with Tom Ford's Oud Wood. Y'all, Oud Wood alone by itself is one of my absolute faves from Tom Ford. Now, my thoughts initially on Tom Ford, I really didn't care for the fragrance line because there are a lot of misses for me in that collection, but there are also a few gems that I just love, and this is one of them. This is an absolute gem in the house of Tom Ford, and I think this is another one that I'm always going to keep in my collection. Now, I know that most men wear this, and I feel like a lot of people think this leans masculine. For me, I think it leans unisex. It's perfectly unisex, and it plays well on my skin. I love this scent. As you can tell, I have the big bottle. But absolutely love this scent. This is an aromatic, woody scent primarily. The oud note in here is really far away in the background, like far, far, far away. Maybe in Timbuktu, far away. Like the oud is not, it's not in the forefront at all, in my opinion. But this scent in general is just an amazing, aromatic, woody scent. I love it. I love it. And when it dries down, there is a hint of sweetness. Now, sometimes I want more amplified sweetness in this scent. I love the aromaticness of this, but sometimes I want it just a little bit sweeter. So what I discovered, and this was kind of on accident, I discovered that Juliet Has a Guns vanilla vibe paired with this. Oh my gosh. Okay. Mind blown. So this is a, of course, vanilla scent, but it's a salty, almost aquatic vanilla. The salty airiness of this vanilla, and this is a natural smelling vanilla. I can tell that this is a very natural smelling vanilla, which I absolutely love. But this paired with this is a beautiful combination, guys. It keeps it aromatic, like I said, but it sweetens it up, and it's not overbearing, it's not overpowering, but it's just, it blends beautifully with this already amazing formulation of oud wood. Absolutely love this discovery. Really, I should patent this because if you try it, I almost guarantee that you'll love it. If you want this a little bit sweeter, I feel like this is the best vanilla to pair with this scent. And this might be TMI, but I was at an appointment and my esthetician, in the middle of her ripping off the strip, she's asking me what was I wearing because she could not get over how good I smelt. I just thought that was hilarious. So yeah, major compliment factor. Please try this out if you have it. I guarantee that you'll love it as well. Okay, so let's just be super honest. The only true guarantees in life are death and taxes. So if you try Tom Ford Oud Wood and Vanilla Vibe and you don't like it, I don't need a lawsuit. Please don't come for me. I'm sorry. I absolutely love that combo and I'm just sharing it for you guys to try it as well. But if you don't like it, I'm sorry. Okay, I'm sorry. So guys, that is the end of my layering combos. I hope I was able to shed some light and share some new combinations that you could possibly try as well in your collection. So let me know down below what your go-to layering combo is, if you don't mind sharing. Help the people out, get some ideas on what layers best with what. So I hope you truly enjoyed this video today. If you like what you saw, go ahead and give me a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed, I truly hope that you'll consider hitting that subscribe button. Also, if you've watched it this far, leave in the comments a thumbs up emoji and I will automatically enter you into a giveaway for my 1,000 subscriber giveaway. I'm going to enter you in a giveaway and I will randomly select a winner and it will be a fragrance, but I will share that in a future video. So I will run this for maybe about a couple weeks and I will select a winner at random. So the rules are simply leave a thumbs up emoji and you have to be subscribed to my channel, and in a couple weeks I will select a winner for this giveaway. Okay guys, this was truly a fun one to film. Until the next time, peace.